I think polling is a phenomenal principle and framework that, you know, applies to, I was reading over a lot of my life, right? And thinking about prioritizing and, you know, perseverance and how I help others, I think it really resonated with me. It was like, okay, this is allowing me to really articulate, like, the things that I want to accomplish, right? When I'm thinking about diversity and inclusion. And so I think it's a helpful way to take a step back and say, okay, you know, how am I living out through these concepts, right? And so I'm someone who likes to reflect often and think about, you know, what am I doing? How does this energize me? And so, you know, I'm all about having a framework to do that. And I think, you know, for me, polling definitely helps provide that context and allows me to be intentional about reflecting on, you know, what I want to accomplish. And so thinking about polling as a concept and sort of how it applies to me, I definitely think that, you know, one of the things I mentioned that describes me is sort of perseverance and passion, right? And I think in being intentional about it, I think from a very young age, you know, working in the school and throughout, you know, my work at the Harlem Children's Zone, I've always been very passionate about helping others and building my community. And I didn't know it then, but a lot of that was building a network, right? And being very thoughtful about the people that I met. And so, like I said, I'm a joiner. I've joined everything. I've done every fellowship, mostly every fellowship in New York City. A lot of my friends will laugh about it, but to me, I enjoy building community, right? And joining, you know, networks with like-minded people, right? And so I think that's how you grow. That's how you sharpen yourself. And that's how you help people, right? I think when you're in a space where folks are there to help each other, right? I think that increases your amount of access and opportunities, and also for the people that you're trying to serve, right? You know, now I can connect my mentor with someone who's working at Morgan Stanley because now they're a part of my network. And so I think, you know, network not just for your own personal benefit, but thinking about sort of others in that context. Leadership is something that I think has always come naturally to me. What I'm learning though is that as you grow as a professional, it's more challenging, right? Because there's so many leaders. There are so many people who have leadership ability, right? And so, you know, what I try to do is think about what makes me unique, right? How do I leverage my background, my story, and be true to like what my leadership ability is? And so I think leadership is integral when you're trying to do work that is difficult, like diversity and inclusion. It's hard, right? And so it requires bold leadership. It requires risk-taking. It requires a network. And, you know, one of the most important principles, I think, of polling for me has been establishing the network. In addition to, you know, networking and growing, I think I've been able to inspire a lot of people. And it sometimes, I think, it's... you don't really sort of celebrate that. It's hard to celebrate that when you're working so hard. You know, and I think social media creates this perception around, you know, how people may perceive you. But I try to really, you know, focus on my journey. And you know, there are people who say, hey, listen, I want to connect with you and figure out more about what you're doing. And I'm the type of person, I'll meet with anyone for coffee because I appreciated that person several years ago that met with me when I was just this kid that had no idea about, you know, what they wanted to be in the world, right? And so I think, again, going back to sort of being intentional, I think, you know, how you get to inspire people is by being available, right? Whether it's answering a text, an email, phone call, grabbing coffee, you know, I really want to connect with as many people as possible. I think, you know, Malcolm Gladwell's tipping point, being a connector. When I read that, I was like, I want to be this person. I want to be able to know people everywhere and inspire people. So I think I don't do it for the inspiration. I do it for the love of it and, you know, my passion. But I think in the process, it's very natural to think about inspiring others. I'm looking forward to meeting that next person over coffee who I can inspire and help to grow and figure out, you know, what can I do to be a part of their lives and their success.